The principle was established that without the shedding of blood, there is no forgiveness. The principle was also established that the innocent must suffer for the guilty. 3,000 years later, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the Lamb of God for sinners slain, innocent and holy, was slaughtered on a Roman cross for your redemption and for your redemption and for mine outside the gates of the city of Jerusalem. Revelation 13:8 says the cross was the destiny of Jesus Christ from the Garden of Eden until the moment he was crucified. John the Revelator writes, the Lamb of God was to be slain from the foundations of the earth. That means that Jesus Christ in the economy of God was planned to die at Calvary before Genesis 1:1 ever happened.
And Christ died on the cross and paid the price for our salvation and redeemed us by the giving of his own blood. I read about a Roman slave girl who was given her freedom, and the girl jumps on the ground and says, you've redeemed me and I will serve you faithfully the rest of my life. Fallen men and women are on the auction block with no one to redeem us. We're lost. We're going to judgment in hell. What are we going to do? That's where Jesus Christ came and died and shed his blood and gave his blood to pay for our sins and to redeem us. And if you are not under the blood, you're not going to go to heaven. You must be under the blood.
The blood of Jesus Christ is supernatural protection for the righteous. The blood of Jesus Christ cleanses you from sin. The Bible says, though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be white as snow. The blood heals your body. By his stripes we are healed. There is no disease, there is no sickness that can match the power of Jesus Christ's blood. The blood protects you from harm and danger. There is literally a bloodline around you. A bloodline that's around you. The blood of Jesus Christ terrifies demon powers. The blood of Christ liberates you from your past and guarantees you your future. Thank you, Father God, for the precious blood of Jesus Christ that died on the cross to redeem us. Hallelujah! Hallelujah for the blood of Jesus Christ. Give him praise in the house. It is the blood that makes the Word of God powerful. It is the blood that terrorizes Satan and every demon in hell. It is the blood that sets the captives free and crushes the chains of oppression. It is the blood that guarantees our salvation and conquers death, hell, and the grave. It is the blood that brings healing, for by his stripes we are healed. It is the blood that breaks generational curses, and some of you are suffering from a generational curse. Galatians 3:13, Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for you at the cross. One drop of precious blood from the veins of the Son of God sets you free from the bondage of sin. It makes your sins, though they be red like crimson, to be whiter than snow. The blood buries your sin in the deepest sea, never, never, never to be remembered against you anymore. Racial issues divide us. The blood unifies us. There is no white church, black church, or brown church. There is only the blood-bought church of Jesus Christ. Jesus commanded us, love one another as I have loved you. When the church starts loving one another, we will become the most powerful fraternity in the United States of America. It's time to stand up and be who we are without apology. Christians who believe the word, practice the word, pray the word, receive the cross in Jesus' name. Give him praise in the house.
When Moses was down in Egypt trying to get the people out of Egypt and trying to get them into the promised land, and he was having these debates with Pharaoh, and you remember that God said, all right, tell them that I'm going to kill the firstborn in all of Egypt tonight, and tell the people, the Jewish people, to go out and slay a lamb without blemish and put the blood on the doorpost, and when I see the blood, I will pass over, not when I see their good works. And that was the beginning of Passover. The slaying of those animals and the blood. God didn't say when I see their good works or even when I see your ethnic background. When I see the blood, tells us about blood from Genesis to Revelation. And many people wonder why God demands blood. The scripture says, for the life of the flesh is in the blood. You see, blood stands for life. When blood leaves your body, that means life is gone.
The blood of Jesus Christ is the only way to salvation. Secular human estate, we are all on different roads going to the same place. Wrong. The Bible says, without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. That God law, not mine. There is no other way to forgiveness other than the blood of Jesus Christ. In Exodus 12, we read that on the night when the death angel passed through Egypt, executing judgment upon the firstborn, he kept the promise that he had made to the children of Israel. The Bible says, and the blood shall be for you a token upon the houses where you are, and when I see the blood, I will pass over you. End of quote. The blood on the doorpost kept the death angel away from that house. Had they put jewels on the side post and diamonds in the door, it would not have kept the death angel away.